Liberty Walk might be one of the most polarizing tuners on the planet. It has become notorious for bandsawing the arches off a multitude of exotic supercars, only to then rivet supersized body kits and slammed suspension set UPS in place. For good or bad, you guys always have something to say about them. We popped in to say hello, heading to Liberty Walk's headquarters in the city of Nagoya, a few hours west of Tokyo. And we have to admit, seeing so many of these INSTAGRAM famous cars in one place was pretty surreal. It also proved that Liberty Walk isn't just a supercar chop shop, it's a place brimming with enthusiasm and hidden treasures. Spread over three buildings and one storage hangar, the Liberty Walk campus is an Aladdin's cave of Japanese car culture. There are small, furiously expensive one-off die-cast models, we're talking £6,000 a pop. There is a hipster cafe, complete with slammed Mercy logo furniture. There are many motorbikes. And then there's Liberty Walk boss Mr. Wataru Kato's personal back catalog of old-school Kyusha and Shakuten cars on display. A bit of history, if you permit. Liberty Walk's been around since 1993, and at its birth represented something of a game-changer. Kato-san wanted to change the perception of car workshops, and started selling body kits for K-cars, then became an American and supercar importer from his neon-lit premises in Japan, a few years ahead of the max power modifying scene, to which he owes his fortune. Subsequently, he sculpted a few body kits for Lamborghinis, the popularity of which heralded a separate subdivision of the company called LB Performance. Now that name's become a mainstay in the rarefied super-wide supercar tuning niche. One that's spearheaded by Kato-san, who owns a custom Ferrari F40, 458, Lamborghini Mercy logo, Aventador and many, many retro Japanese cars fabricated in all kinds of weird and wacky ways.